Evolutionary computation is inspired by natural evolution. The way it works is kind of somewhat counterintuitive. As engineers, we're used to engineering a solution, kind of coming up with the best that we can, and then kind of debugging it and deploying it. In evolutionary computation, all we have to do is define the container. What does the solution actually look like? And what are the ingredients? The system then generates randomly solutions that are viable, but they're not necessarily good because obviously they were put together randomly. So now these solutions are not going to be very good, but if we have a means to measure relatively which is, you know, less bad than the other, then we can rank order all these solutions that we generated randomly. We then remove the worst ones, retain the ones that are a little bit better, and then in the next generation, when we create some more candidate solutions, we mix and match and beg and borrow from those solutions that were less bad in the last generation. And we go through this loop over and over and over again, and lo and behold, what happens is that oftentimes we're able to come up with solutions. Note that these are not engineered, not designed by humans, but that are actually viable and interesting solutions to the problem at hand. Evolutionary computation has some very interesting characteristics, one of which is that it is inherently parallelizable. So you can actually scale it very easily and run it on multiple machines across geographies, and it works quite well that way.